In this video, we're actually looking at a piece of the Millikan oil drop experiment, but we're not trying to go into the details of the entire experiment. Someday I'll make that video, but today all we're looking at is the balancing between the force of gravity downward on an oil droplet and the electric force upward on the droplet, given that it has a single excess electron on it. So we have this suspended droplet with, of course, the force of gravity pulling down on it with a magnitude of mg. And it's between these two plates, and we have a potential difference across these plates in order to create an electric field. We actually want the electric field to point down so that the force on an electron points up. And the magnitude of that electric force is given by QE, where Q is the charge on an electron. So in part A, we're asked for the electric field required for the oil drop to stay in place. In other words, to balance the force of gravity. So if we get this oil droplet to be at equilibrium, then mg, the force of gravity, has to be equal to q times e, where our charge is given by the elementary charge, the charge on the electron. All I have to do here is solve for capital E, the electric field, and then we plug the numbers in. Our droplet is 10 to the negative 15 kilograms. G, we'll use the approximation 9.8, and then the charge on the electron. And we're just speaking in magnitudes here. I'm not worried about the minus sign in front. That minus sign really just takes care of the direction of the force, which we already did in the diagram. And when I run the numbers on this, I get an electric field strength of 61,250 volts per meter. Now keep in mind, you could also express those units as newtons per coulomb, but I thought it was most relevant to express this in terms of volts per meter because of the follow-up question. So in part B, we want to get the potential difference required to generate this electric field. And we mark that as a V in the diagram. Well, the electric field strength is determined by the potential difference you have, the number of volts, divided by the distance you spread that potential difference over. In other words, this 5 centimeter plate separation. As a formula, it looks like this. E is equal to V over D. So all we have to do here is solve for V, and I get V equals ED. Express those centimeters in meters as 0.05. Into 3 sig figs, we get 3,060 volts, or if you prefer, 3.06 kilovolts. And we're done with the problem. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.